Hello and welcome again to Immigration News and Views. My name is David Nachman. I'm one of the managing attorneys at the Nachman Fawani Zemochek Law Group. We have offices located in Ridgewood, New Jersey. We also have an office in Midtown Manhattan. We also have an office in Princeton, New Jersey, which is one of our newest offices. We also have an office in affiliated offices in Mumbai, India, in Gujarat, in India, in Ahmedabad, and we also have affiliated offices in Canada, in Montreal, and Toronto. We are also opening a new office in Indianapolis, Indiana, and we will tell you more about that office soon. And the reason why I'm coming to you today is that we received a very, very interesting question from one of our clients by email this morning, and it gave me an opportunity to sit back and reflect a little bit on bringing to our viewers' attention a very interesting tool that might be of some assistance in the future. So what that tool is, it's called Nunc pro Tunc. Nunc pro Tunc means in Latin, now for then, and it's a tool that's used by immigration lawyers, immigration practitioners, oftentimes when you have certain gaps that might occur in filings. So it's essentially used as a remedial methodology that goes back and bridges over certain times that maybe something should have been filed. So let me give you an example where Nunc pro Tunc might work. Let's say, for example, you have an individual who is in the United States as a visitor for pleasure, and they are traveling throughout the country, and for some reason they forget to file their extension, and they realize 2 days after they fought that 2 days after they should have filed their extension for their visitor's visa that they didn't do it. So what they would do is they would come to us and they would say, "Oh, I overstayed by 2 days. I know that I'm out of status, and I know that I overstayed my visa, so under section 221G of the law, the visa would be void, and of course, you begin to accrue unlawful presence. However, just because you overstayed does not mean that you're precluded from taking a shot at filing a Nunc pro Tunc I-539 request for an extension of status." And so what you would do is you would file that I-539 and you would essentially ask the government to consider the application, what's called Nunc pro Tunc, now for then. And so what it is that you would ask them to sort of bootstrap the application going back to when it should have been filed, on the date it should have been filed. So in this example that I'm giving, obviously 2 days is not too egregious, and the government does have the discretion, assuming several things, other things which we'll talk about, assuming those other factors, the government could grant a Nunc pro Tunc application and could extend the visitor's visa. The only thing is that obviously if you decide to utilize that Nunc pro Tunc tool, you have to be really careful to keep an eye on the 180 days of unlawful presence that you're beginning to toll, because the filing of a Nunc pro Tunc application does not toll unlawful presence, which you would have obviously if you had filed the application before your status expired. So that's of course the risk. But the way that it works is that you file a normal 539 application, and what you do is you ask the government to consider it, as I mentioned before, Nunc pro Tunc. So the government will take into account certain factors. The first factor the government will look at is whether or not it's a reasonable or an unreasonable period of time. So the example I gave before about 2 days, that's a possibility that the government would in fact consider that application Nunc pro Tunc if you have that coupled with another factor, which is that it was beyond your control to be able to have been to be able to have submitted your application in a timely manner. So where this might frequently come up is in a situation like this. Let's say an individual goes to a notario, and the notario says, "Oh yeah, 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 I'll take care of your filing and don't worry about it." And this is actually what we see frequently. They go to a notario, and a notario is not a lawyer. A notario is an individual who holds themselves out as doing immigration services when they're not in fact licensed to do those immigration services. So they're not affiliated with a law office. They're just sort of, it's like a shop that sells insurance, immigration, mortgages, and etc. Okay, so they say, okay, we'll take care of your application. What happens is they sit on it and they wait too long. And unfortunately, they wait, let's say, 3 or 4 days beyond the date. And all of a sudden, you call up the notary and you say, did you submit my application? They say no. So you grab that application, you take it, and you go to a lawyer, and the lawyer says, well, you know, it was really beyond your control. The notario was sitting on it. They induced your reliance, and they told you that they were going to file it in a timely manner. So what we're going to do is we're going to take that application, and we're going to file it nunc pro tunc, and we're going to ask them, because it was beyond your control, to consider the date of filing to be bootstrapped back to the date prior to the expiration. And in many cases, we've utilized the nunc pro tunc methodology of being able to bootstrap, and it saved our clients a tremendous amount of headaches. And oftentimes, we have clients who, unfortunately, can't travel are leery of traveling. And so the nunc pro tunc instrument or tool is tremendously valuable. Just recently, we had an individual who came to our office whose lawyer, unfortunately, was sitting on an application too long and didn't file for an extension of his H-4 status. And what ended up happening is that he went out of status and there was a gap of about 2 or 3 months. So his spouse, of course, was working in valid H-1B status. The H-1B status was not keyed to the H-4, which oftentimes happens, where the H-1B will be expiring at a different date than the H-4. All of a sudden, he realized that his H-4 had expired about 30 days ago, and he asked us, what can he do? And he knew he was out of status. So what we did is we invoked the nunc pro tunc methodology, and we tried to bootstrap his H-4 back to when it should have been filed. The government, utilizing its discretion, obviously felt that we had prepared a decent case. And what they did was they went ahead and favorably adjudicated it, hearkening back to when he should have filed the H-4. So he didn't have to leave the country to get the new visa. So I bring this to your attention only in case you have certain situations where you believe that you might not have an option because you may have overstayed or something of the like. Please feel free to reach out for a qualified immigration professional who can assist you in understanding the nuances of the immigration law, such as the nunc pro tunc methodology. Thanks very much for tuning in today, and we look forward to seeing you soon. Bye for now.